The Antonio Project present Mooring Rig Test or Render Test for Split Drum Mooring Means.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. At this time, I would like to share about Rig Power Test or Render Test, how to calculate and procedure how to carry out Rig Power Test. You can download the Rig Power Test calculation freely. Please find the download link on the below description. The calculation and the procedure of this video is only for reference. For details, let's check out the video and the animation. Let's go.
Mooring Rig Power Test or Render Testing is a periodic load test and calibration of a mooring means rig at a load based on the equipment number assigned to the ship. The purpose is, when ship is moored, means rig and lines are expected to keep the vessel safely alongside. When environmental parameter change due to factors such as wind, current, swell passing vessel surge, excessively and trim, the windsprig should be set as the weakest point of the mooring system.
Rather than parting mooring line or damaging mooring wind structure and fittings, the windsprig should render so that the vessel can be brought back alongside safely. Conversely, the vessel should not move away from the berth due to the effect of external forces less than the minimum brake load parameters. Ship design minimum braking load or SDMBL should be the initial reference for brake holding capacity or BHC test. When a ship is built, the mooring winches are equipped with mooring lines of an MBL roughly equal to the SDMBL. In cases where a greater strength line is used, the line MBL can be higher than the design MBL, but must always be less than the mooring fitting, Goulard, Chalk, etc. SWL value. It is imperative, therefore, brake holding capacity test calculation must be based on the SDMBL and not the line MBL.
Regular wind brake render testing and calibration should significantly contribute to safe mooring. Following is the type of the mooring winch seeing from the winding drum construction. Split drum mooring winch is a winch with drum divided by a notch flange into a tension section and a line storage section. Non-split drum mooring winch is the undivided drum winches. Both tension section and storage section are in one drum.
Brake test or render test procedure for winch drum. Before brake test, check that the brake lining surface is continuously touched on brake drum. Tighten the brake of testing drum surely and disengage the clutch. Install the test kit with pins. Put the hydraulic on the lower edge point of the test kit. Adjust the height of hydraulic jack on foundation. During jack-up operation, it is necessary to tighten the brake handle again. While paying attention to each part, raise the pressure by hand-operated pump and read the scale of attached pressure gauge. Brake holding capacity can be found the value gained from pressure gauge. After the test is finished, operate it in the reverse procedure of above description. After the brake testing is complete, the lock nut for indicator is correctly adjusted. Turn the lock nut for indicator number 205 until the lock nut for indicator touch the bearing housing number 201, and then adjust the indicator arrow number 105 to correspondent to the middle of indicator ring number 106. Consequently, it is most important to check that there is no gap between two lock nut number 205 for indicator and bearing housing number 201. If a gap, the brake holding load will be lower than tested load.
Warning: prepare a brake test bracket which is strong and stable enough to support the force. After making sure that the brake test bracket is set on level, operate the hand pump carefully enough not to walk off
the brake test bracket. If the brake test bracket is worked off, you may encounter injury. B in capital letter meaning is diameter of drum, and the diameter of drum is 748 mm. Meanwhile, small d is diameter of rope, and the diameter of rope is 70 mm. And next is L. L is the distance between center of the drum and center of the bracket. At this time, the distance is 1105 mm. Next is the calculation. At first, we will measure the distance drum center to rope center, or R. The diameter of drum is D. The value of the diameter is 748, and then we can enter 748 to the column. Then the diameter of wire or rope is small d. The value is 70 mm, and we can input to the column. The result of the calculation of the distance drum center to rope for first layer is 40.9. And for second layer, the distance from the drum center to rope is 47.9 cm. For third layer, the distance is 54.9 cm. For split drum, the distance drum center to rope center, we use first layer. For non-split drum, it is depend into how many layer used during operation. Depend into the ship design. At present, I'm using 150 ton for ship design minimum braking load, and the 60% of minimum braking load is 90 ton. And for 80% minimum braking load for SDMBL 150 is 120 ton. Next is calculation of brake force. Brake force for 60% MBL or 90 ton. Next is inputting distance from drum center to jack center. The distance is 1105 mm, and I will input 110.5 cm. And next, inputting jack area value. Usually, we can find the jack area value on the instruction manual for hydraulic jack. If you unable to find the instruction manual or the jack area, you can calculate on this worksheet. And this is the instruction manual showing the jack area. The jack area is 132.7, and the cylinder bore is 130 mm. I will calculate jack area based on known cylinder bore, 130 mm or 13 cm. And the result is same with the instruction manual. The jack area value is 132.7 cm². I will input jack area to the column, 132.7. Next column is distance from drum center to rope center. Since I'm measuring the brake test for split drum, so I'm using first layer, and that is 40.9 cm. And the result is the jack pressure to be applied for 90 tons or 60% MBL is 24.6 MPa or 250 kg force per square centimeter, and jack force is 33.3 ton. And for 80% MBL or 120 ton, the check pressure is 32.8 megapascal or 335 kilogram force per square centimeter, and jack force is 44.4 ton. And you can calculate based on the second layer, third layer, or different jack area. This brake test calculation worksheet can be downloaded freely. Please find the link on the description below for free download. Single acting hydraulic cylinder is the jack which is only extended by pressure from a pump, then retracted by weight of the load or by inbuilt spring. The calculation of load applied to the mooring brake using cylinder effective area or jack area. Different hydraulic jack will change the result of the calculation. Always check cylinder effective area of each hydraulic jack. Usually, jack area described on the instruction manual or nameplate of hydraulic jack, or it can be calculated using cylinder bore power and pressure of the jack. Make sure that the pressure gauge is calibrated and the value is correct. Next is installing mooring brake test kit. At first, install drum brackets, pins, and secure with safety pin. There are two pieces brackets for left and right of the drum. Next, install brackets connecting arm, pins, and secure with safety pin. Place hydraulic jack foundation brackets centering to the bracket arm. Then, place hydraulic jack above the foundation bracket. Connect hydraulic hose from hand pump to hydraulic jack. Then, adjust the height of hydraulic jack until touching bracket arm. Don't forget to secure test kit with a locking wire and lock with a shackle to avoid the test kit being slipping. Mooring Winch Brake Test Kit, Hydraulic Hand Pump, Foundation Bracket, Single Acting Hydraulic Jack, bracket arm, pin, and safety pin, drum bracket. Deshackle. Next is locking wire. Following is the procedures of render test or brake test for mooring winch. First step is measure brake holding capacity 60% of MBL. Brake force is 90 tons and jack pressure is 24.6 bar. At first, tighten the brake to the previous marking. increase hydraulic jack pressure slowly by pumping the hydraulic manual hand pump and watch carefully the increasing of pressure on the pressure gauge. When pressure unable to rise up, it means that the brake is not tight and unable to hold the jack force, and it is necessary to be retightened. Retighten the brake in order to increase brake power to the mooring drum. Then again increase hydraulic jack pressure by pumping hydraulic manual pump. When the pressure is over the desired 24.6 bar, it means that the brake is too tight and it is necessary to be loosened. Before loosening the brake, release the hydraulic jack pressure by opening hand pump releasing valve. Then loosen the brake few turns. After that, increase the hydraulic pressure slowly by pumping hydraulic hand pump. Carefully check the pressure on the pressure gauge. When the pressure drop, take the measurement. As you can see, that the pressure dropped at about 25 bar and followed by bang sound when the mooring drum is slipping. It means that the brake holding capacity is 90 ton or 60% of MBL. After completion of setting brake holding capacity to 60% of MBL, then adjust marking on the brake handle by loosening locking bolt and set the marking to line up to arrow. Then tighten the lock nut in order to prevent movement of the marking. Next stage, setting brake holding capacity to 80% of MBL. The brake force is 120 tons and the jack pressure is 32.8 bar. At first, tighten the brake as previous 80% of MBL marking. Then increase the pressure of hydraulic jack by pumping hydraulic hand pump. Watch carefully the pressure on the pressure gauge. The target pressure is 32.8 bar. As you can see that the pressure is over than 35 bars. It means that the brake is over tightened and it is necessary to be loosened. Before loosening of the brake, reduce the hydraulic jack pressure by opening the pressure releasing valve. After releasing hydraulic jack pressure, slowly turn the brake handle in order to reach 80% of MBL. Then pump the hydraulic hand pump and keep on eye of the pressure. The brake holding capacity value can be read from value of the pressure gauge. As you can see, the pressure about 33 bar and suddenly drop and it is followed by bang sound from mooring drum. It means that the brake holding capacity 80% is about 33 bar. After completion of setting brake holding capacity to 80% MBL, then adjust marking on the brake handle by loosening locking bolt and set the marking to line up to arrow. Then tighten the lock nut. Next is adjustment of lock nut for indicator. Technically, brake holding capacity of a winch is 80% of the MBL mooring rope, but it is set at 60% of the MBL, allowing 20% margin for safety, as per OCIEMF guideline. Following is the video about how to conduct brake power test or rendering test. And this is the setup process of mooring brake test kit. Remember to always use personal protective equipment and to carry out risk assessment for safe working. Adjustment of height of hydraulic jack and securing the test kit to avoid warp off and injure the worker. After all the mooring brake test kit being set up, then continue to pressurize hydraulic jack to the mooring wheel. Brake rendering is the slipping of brake, resulting in release of load or stress on the tightened mooring line before the mooring rope on it reaches its MBL or minimum braking load. Brake holding capacity is the maximum capacity of the mooring wheel's brake to hold the mooring drum in its position when under tension. The brake holding capacity of it is required to be 80% of the MBL of the rope. This is applied to new ship. Keeping 20% of the MBL as the safety margin, the holding capacity is required to be set at 60% of the MBL. When the winch drum is subjected to the load in excess of 60% of the MBL, the brake should render. Ship design minimum braking load or SDMBL. The minimum braking load of new dry mooring lines for which a ship mooring system is designed to meet OCIMF standard environmental criteria restraint requirement. Line design brake force or LDBF. LDBF is the minimum force that a new dry supplies mooring line brake at when tested according to appendix B. Split drum mooring winches must use the calculation based on one layer of line on the tension side of the split drum, such as to replicate a normal moor condition of maximum one layer of rope on the tension drum. Undivided mooring winches become a bit more difficult, and it is recommended that the manufacturers to be consulted in terms of how many line layers should be used in the calculation. When testing an undivided drum using one layer, the effect of doing this that rendering will occur at 11% less force for a second layer of line and 25% less force for a fourth layer of line. When the test is completed and the brake setting is calibrated, the winch will need to be marked with a marking device to ensure that the brake is applied with the same torque at every mooring operation. The mooring winch brake rendering test should be carried out at intervals, preferably in annual basis or as per company instruction.
I think that's all my video. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe button. By subscribing my channel, you have contributed to the development of my channel. If you have any questions, suggestions or advice, please write your comment on the description below. See you in my next video and other time. Bye bye.
Thank you for watching my video. If you like my Seafarer educational video, please click like and subscribe button. The Antonio Project.